Greetings, fellow human. I'm Rose from happyandauthentic.com, and you're watching my series on how to be happy. This week's happiness strategy is to overcome imposter syndrome. Just to clarify, there is a huge difference between being an imposter and suffering from imposter syndrome. A real imposter pretends or claims to be able to do something despite not having the skills, the background, or the experience. Someone who just feels like an imposter isn't purposefully lying or deceiving anyone. They didn't cheat or fabricate anything, and they actually earned their achievement. They simply feel unworthy of it. Imposter syndrome is a psychological phenomenon that makes people feel like frauds, despite being intelligent, skillful, and experienced people. They might be unable to accept praise for their accomplishments, dismiss them as luck, or even feel like they're tricking people into thinking they're smarter and more capable than they believe themselves to be. These people don't believe they deserve praise for their successes, and they often feel paranoid that they'll be exposed for faking it. People who experience imposter syndrome are impervious to objective evidence. Even though everyone else might be able to see that they have obviously earned their achievements, they're convinced that they didn't. A common emotion associated with imposter syndrome is the sense that you're the only person who feels this way. Like everyone else successful actually deserves it, but you're the only one who doesn't. This, of course, is not true. 70% of humanity experiences similar feelings from time to time, so you're definitely not alone if you feel like this. It's especially common when beginning a new job or project, particularly if you're taking over the position of someone who was well-liked and did a fantastic job. If you don't know everything you expect you should know, it leads to doubts and worries. You might tell yourself you're stupid, useless, or simply unworthy of the position. And none of these feelings make any logical sense. A lot of us know it's unrealistic to expect to know everything immediately, but we tend to confuse emotions with facts. If you'd like some advice on how to stop doing this, check out this video about emotional signals. Like I said there, feelings are not facts. Just because you feel like a fraud, that is not proof that you actually are a fraud. However, if you let these feelings convince you that it's true, it can become a self-fulfilling prophecy, which will only reinforce your idea that you're an imposter. Another quote-unquote symptom of imposter syndrome is that these feelings are a secret you feel compelled to keep. You're terrified that if you bring attention to them, others might suddenly notice that you're a fraud and confirm that your worst fears are actually true. These paranoid feelings get worse the more successful you become, as expectations get higher and higher. In today's world of pervasive online presences, imposter syndrome is getting much harder to control. We're all expected to sell ourselves aggressively while somehow still remaining authentic. So we feel like we need to be perfect while also being ourselves. But like I said in this video about how to be authentic, being 100% who you are means being free to fail sometimes, because true authenticity inevitably comes with making mistakes. When you try to be sincere while also being very self-conscious and hyper-aware of how you present yourself, it can intensify feelings of being a fraud. I feel that way pretty much all the time. Running a business that promotes happiness and authenticity puts a lot of pressure on me to always be happy and authentic. But those two things don't always go together. Sometimes being authentic means acknowledging I don't always feel happy. Not to mention the anxiety of not knowing whether my audience will consider writing my scripts beforehand to be authentic enough. It's hard to find a middle ground that pleases everyone, so yeah, I get it. The main attribute of those suffering from imposter syndrome is that they discount their own achievements while overestimating the achievements of others. For ourselves, we tend to push the bar higher and higher out of reach, and this mainly happens due to a cognitive distortion called black or white thinking, also known as all or nothing thinking. This is when you consider yourself a failure for making one tiny mistake, even when 99% of the project overall went pretty well. If you'd like more details on how to tackle cognitive distortions like this, click here. You'd be surprised to see how many of them you actually have. Anyway, the perfectionism that's usually at the core of imposter syndrome actually comes from a need for external validation, as a result of not being able to internalize your own success and focusing more on what you haven't done rather than on what you've already achieved. This often also comes with ambivalent feelings towards success, because you might recognize that it could lead to more responsibility, that you're uncertain you merited in the first place. Another common cause of imposter syndrome is comparing your level 1 with someone else's level 10. I spoke about this in more detail in my video about comparing yourself only to yourself. Basically, if you're new at writing novels, for example, your first draft is not going to seem as good as the published works of prominent authors with years of experience. But as social creatures, we've always looked to other humans to see if we're on track. If the people around us are less skilled than us, we feel good about ourselves. But if they're highly skilled, we don't seem to measure up in comparison, even though our skill level remains the same in both cases. The thing is, our social circle has effectively become the entire planet in today's world of interconnectivity. So it's very likely we will hear of someone who is better than us at something that means a lot to us. Click here if you'd like to learn some tips on how to overcome these feelings of not being good enough, or if you'd just like to learn how to stop comparing yourself to other people. At its core, imposter syndrome starts from the fact that we can't read the minds of anyone other than ourselves. So by definition, we can only compare our inner world of worries, doubts, and slip-ups to the competent exterior of effortless success and obvious self-confidence that other people portray. Social media tends to amplify this because when we look at other people's profiles, all we see are the highlights, what seems like a streak of peak experiences. But we're well aware of the many valleys in our own lives, so it looks like everyone else is having a better time than us. They seem so much more put together, more capable, and more confident. So we feel like we're only pretending to have these attributes while thinking that others actually have them. We don't see just how scared or unsure other people feel, especially if they're good at putting on a brave face. We don't see the years of trial and error that came before their achievements. All we see is the perfect image they project. At this point, you might be wondering, if so many people experience imposter syndrome, is it even a bad thing? Why even worry about it? We can just suck it up and live with it, right? Well, yes and no. It's technically not the worst thing in the world, but even in minor cases, it can still inconvenience your life. You might talk yourself out of applying for jobs you're perfectly qualified for, or never take any steps toward realizing your dreams. Whereas in more severe cases, it could actually be a major cause of stress, paranoia, and emotional duress, all of which can potentially weaken your body physically and cause serious health issues. So, in light of what we have to gain by overcoming this frustrating condition, I'm here to propose some solutions. But because there's quite a few of them, and I want to be thorough, I included them in an article called A Fraud's Cheat Sheet to Overcoming Imposter Syndrome. You can find it on my website, happyandauthentic.com, or you can just click the link in the description down below. That way, this video won't get too long, and you can follow the instructions at your own pace. If you'd like my help putting these steps into action, comment below or click the link in the description to book a free Skype session. If you're new to the series, subscribe and you'll get a new video every Sunday. I also have a newsletter that you can sign up for if you'd like weekly happiness tips in your inbox. Just click the link below. Anyway, I'll see you when I see you. Until then, remember, happiness doesn't require energy. It requires strategy.